So here's our jig to hold our barrels in place at the proper orientation to where they can't move, and then do our plunge routing down into them. So this is going to slip in here like this, and then the other one's going to come up, come in here like this, and these are all exactly the same width. So I'll be able to line this up. I'm going to screw these down and screw these down into our waste block. And what I'm also going to do is, here in a second, I'm going to take my one of my thin Japanese saws and I'm going to cut a slot all the way down in the front. So when I, after I put this on to locate where the plunge is going to go, see, that's going to ride down and be able to be, get clamped onto the edge of this 8/4 board. So I line this up, get that just perfectly lined up, reach in here, rotate it. But then since I cut that slot in there, I'm going to be able to put some serious clamps on here that will pinch. This will be open, so it'll be like a collet. When I pinch this, it will pinch the barrel front and back to keep it from being able to rotate. And so I'll be able to use the same setup for both of them. So I'll just take this off, and then I'll just put the one with the bigger holes for the liptis on it, and do the same thing. So rotate it, get it just right, put some screws down in here, cut a slot in the top, pinch that, and so let me just get my Japanese saw, and I want to cut these guys right now and just be done with it. So this is my 0.3 millimeter Japanese saw, and I'm just gonna cut. I'm gonna try to bisect that line as perfectly as I can. I'm gonna slip a little thing in here so I don't just come through and then hit my nice saw on that. Okay, so when I put this in here now, and then I put a clamp on it. See, it pinches it. Well, that's not, well, I'm gonna have to take a little bit more off. It didn't get quite enough. I'm gonna have to cut a bigger kerf than that. That's it. That does it right there. You know, that's going to be enough. That's going to be enough pressure. Yeah, that'll be no problem. Okay. Let me cut the rest of these, and I'm just going to cut on both sides of the line, but I still have this line down here on the bottom that I can use for orientation, and this on the inside. So, you know, you're always having to adjust your scheme whenever you're woodworking. You can never plan it out and see that far in advance. Things are always revealing themselves and making you change your strategy. Here's the little maple one in place right now. There's quite a bit of friction on this, and so what I did is I brought this up and I squared it to the edge of my board, made sure everything was nice and square here, screwed that down, then did the same thing to this side with this inside it. And So all I have to do is just remove these screws to take it off. Now, I cut the slots bigger so there'll be more pinch when I want to lock it down. Now here, this is just going to ride up on top of it. I'm going to slip over it, and I'll use the center line that I can see here, and I'll just line it up with the center line on the top of the barrel, and then make sure that, I kind of moved a little bit here. Get that nice and plumb. And I can use these rapid action clamps to now clamp these sides down to our 8/4 board, which is clamped to my table. So it can't go anywhere. It's down, it's locked down in place. And then let me just get two more to pinch here that will lock our cylinder in its holder. Let me go find two more. Oh, here's one. Oh, I see the other one. Oh yeah, I see that thing squashing it, pinching it in. Let me get that shot here. Okay, so I have that clamp and I'm ready to pinch this in now. So that is locked. It can't rotate at all. So I'm ready to put my plunge router up on top of here and plunge. What I think I'm going to do is mark the top with the plunge router, mark my rectangle. That gets, and then I'm going to take a hand drill and I'm going to drill down through this maple to relieve a little bit of material. I'll drill it with a quarter inch bit or something like that, just to waste a little bit of material and to give the chips somewhere to blow to. It's quite a lot to. That bit is not the newest, freshest bit, and it's a straight bit and not a spiral fluted bit. But I don't have a half inch spiral fluted bit that long right now, so I'm going to have to make it work. I've got my collector hooked up, but I think the collection's going to be almost non-existent because it's not going to be able to pull through that little tiny opening there and with this closed off box. So this whole inside of this box is just going to be filled with chips. That's one of the other reasons I want to drill a hole down in there. So let me just start. Damn it, I just clipped the inside of our jig right there. I don't know if it's gonna affect the way the thing's gonna ride. Doesn't feel like it. It may be below it. Yeah, I forgot that bit is so long that it doesn't retract all the way back up into the. Here, look down in here and see what I'm talking about. See where I clipped it right here? I may put a little bit of 5-minute epoxy on it and float it out, because otherwise the router is going to want to follow that little impression and make a mess. But I'll go ahead and epoxy that real quick, float, and then I can just float it out with it. You know, I don't want to remove this at all. And then I'm going to drill some holes down in there, but I'll do the epoxy real quick first. Make a quick and dirty repair. So there are the holes that I drilled in the bottom, and then here's where I made my epoxy repair right here. Put a little piece of tape to kind of hold it from drizzling down there too much. Should be ready in a couple minutes, and I'll just peel it off and then just float it out with a file. I'll be much more careful about not trying to extract the router from the hole until the bit has stopped. All right, my repair is done, and I'm gonna try not to make that same mistake again. So I'm gonna let the router come all the way to a complete stop before I lift it out. Man, I'm not all the way through yet. I may have to adjust this jig a little bit lower for the other one because it's thicker. Let me raise this up. I think I can get a little bit more. Oh yeah, I'm all the way through. Let's take it out and look at it. Woo! I may have to make a little adjustment. Oh, that's sweet. Now that is sweet. That is gonna be clean looking. I like it.